Welcome, good people. My name is Joel Collier, and today we're going to talk about how to use summary data, correlation matrix, or even covariance matrix in test and mediation. So in AMOS here, I've got a simple kind of path model. There's two IVs, which is one was adaptive behavior, and this came from a restaurant setting. So did the server adapt their behavior, and did that lead to customer delight? And did that lead to positive word of mouth of their experience, and were they more tolerant for future failures? And there was another independent variable called ServiceScape, which was kind of the built environment around the service, lighting, furnishings, decor, and how that kind of influenced customer delight as well. So let's say we wanted to run this mediation test, but it was not with the raw, I don't have the raw data. Let's say I only had summary data, or I'm trying to recreate it even from a, let's say a journal article that, or a book where I saw that they had presented the results and they had given the kind of the summary data, which is means and standard deviations, maybe correlations. But I wanted to go back and try to run this myself then. Well, I don't have the raw data, and so AMOS is going to require you to have some slight little tweaks in the process to actually run mediation when you don't have the actual raw data itself. So from this kind of path model here, you can see, and when we go into SPSS, that the format here is, and I've recorded a another video if you're looking for more information on how to set up the formats of summary data for AMOS to read. I've got those that you can look up. But you can see here, of all my constructs of adapt and ServiceScape and delight and word of mouth, I've kind of set it up as a summary data. And this is a correlation matrix here, because you can tell by the CORR on the left-hand side. And so for each one of those, going down the diagonals of 1, again, we're denoting correlation. And you can see on the last rows, I've got the standard deviation and the means for each one of our constructs. So again, I've got all of the summary data. I've also got the sample size I need to put in at the top. And so I'm going to use this sample data, but I want to test mediation with this sample data. And if I don't kind of do some tweaks, AMOS will kind of bomb out on me. So let's go back to our AMOS here. And so we want to test mediation. Let's say I've adaptive behavior through delight to positive word of mouth. Now to do that, we first need to add the direct effect, because we don't want to piecemeal our mediation test and just look at just the indirect effect. We want to look at the indirect effect in the presence of the direct effect as well. So we need to add a direct effect from adapt to positive word of mouth. So now let's go into our analysis properties. And what we want to do to test mediation is we want to perform a bootstrap. So we're going to click the bootstrap perform. It defaults to 200, but we're going to change that to 5,000 because 200 is just way too small. And then we're going to do a click on the bias corrected confidence interval. The default is 90, but let's change that to 95. And in the analysis output, we're going to click indirect, direct, and total effects here at the top as well. Now, since we don't have the raw data, if we, and this is typically how we would test mediation, even if we had the raw data. So if I go ahead and run the calculate estimates, what's going to happen is you're going to get kind of an error message here saying, hey, you're trying to run a bootstrap and you don't have raw data. And so what will happen is you may have some kind of wildly different kind of outcomes. You really, if you're having summary data, you really need to match that up to, from the bootstrap perspective, to kind of match up to your summary data when it does its analysis and it does this sampling kind of over and over and over and kind of create that pseudo population. You want it to kind of match kind of the summary data that you've provided. So what we need to do is in the bootstraps, we actually need to click on here where it says Monte Carlo parametric bootstrap. And again, what this does is it's going to try to have the bootstrap kind of match our summary data in regards to its output that it's given versus, you know, correlation means, standard deviations, and that kind of stuff. So we have one more kind of step we need to do to run kind of our bootstrap when we don't have kind of raw data. So now if we run the analysis, you can see that we have no error messages. And if we go into the output, down in the estimates, we can see that our adapt to delight was significant. And you can also see that the delight to positive word of mouth was significant, a T value of 7. But our adapt to positive word of mouth was non-significant. Now, if I ran this data with the raw data versus the summary data here, you're probably going to see, you know, kind of slight differences in the output. Now, they're not going to be very huge, though. So I ran this data in a previous video about how to test for mediation through this, and that T value for that adapt to positive word of mouth was like a 1.8, 86 or an 89, and now it's kind of a 1.79. And the reason why is, again, is because we're using kind of summary data and we're not using the raw data, so it won't match up exactly because you've got rounding issues that's going on there instead of kind of the raw data. But the data should be very similar. You're going to see some slight variation, but nothing's going to be huge. Now, when we actually go into our matrices under the estimates and go down to the indirect effects, you can see here we've got our indirect effect, but we also want to see kind of the confidence interval. So if we go down to bootstrap, confidence intervals down here, we'll get the lower bound and the upper bound. And so our confidence interval did not cross over 0 from the lower to the upper bound. So that usually indicates that there's significance there as well. And so you can see down here, it gives you a p-value of AMOS, which was the significance of the p was less than 0.001. And so now our analysis is very similar and almost mirrors the analysis of the mediation that we ran if it was just straight raw data. So again, not much really changes in the process and the output once you kind of get some of the steps on the front end kind of figured out. But, you know, you have to use this as more kind of a Monte Carlo bootstrap because of the summary data. And then once you do that, everything should be presented just like it normally is in most kind of mediation tests. And if you're looking for more information, like I said, I have a video earlier that talks about how to test mediation in AMOS, or if you're just looking for more information about even more advanced aspects of mediation, serial mediation, parallel mediation, or even moderated mediation, I encourage you to check out my book, Applied Structural Equation Modeling Using AMOS. And as always, if you saw value in this video, I would ask you that you'd like and subscribe. And I hope y'all have a great day, good people.